We return to league action here in Newcastle United, fresh from causing the upset of the round in midweek when they defeated Real Madrid at the Santiago Bernabéu Stadium in Spain. We'll try to repeat the trick here and recover from the loss on the opening day. They won one and lost one in the league, and now face Aston Villa, who come to St. James's Park. Not quite sure what to expect. No one's picked up a minor injury, so he will be missing today. Howard Bellis will get another crack at starting a game today. Javier Mascherano doesn't look so well, so he's going to make way for Jude Bellingham, who makes his debut today. Rafael Leao will be on the bench, and Keenan Knight will come in for Adama Traore. Gareth Bale will continue. Castona starts today ahead of the injured Luan. So we'll see how that goes. In fact, I'm going to start with Alan Saint-Maximin instead, and Keenan Knight can play off the bench. Let's look at Aston Villa again. Jack Grealish, the youngster there, developing nicely. Captain. But Dwight Yorke remains the danger man and the only one worth mentioning in the build-up. So, can Newcastle pull off another win here and make it 2 wins from 3 in the league? They'll still be on something of a high from that win against Real Madrid, possibly one of the Champions League favourites. And it wasn't just a win, guys. Going into the 90 minutes, we were still 1-0 down. And both our goals came in injury time.
Well, good day to you.
We stole it!
A great day here,
and I'm very happy about that. So, Aston Villa, led by Jack Grealish, who remains a target for me, I gotta say. I do want to sign him. It doesn't look like Man City need him in this guise, in this world. I don't really need him that much. Let's see. Maybe I do, maybe I don't. But Shearer will kick off here. Alan Saint-Maximin, who lost his place as a regular starter since the arrival of Gareth Bale. And he needs a good game here today. Newcastle have been going a bit hot and cold, you know. Win one, lose one. Win one, lose one. And, whoa. And Dwight Yorke. Oh, my goodness. He's hit the upright. Castanha trying to win that one back. And Newcastle, yeah, just busy chasing shadows at the moment.
He's delivered all right.
And Douglas Luiz opens the scoring for Aston Villa. My word, they were all over Newcastle there. Dwight Yorke, Luiz there, dribble past one, dribble past the second, and unleashed a ferocious drive past Shea Given. Ross Barkley, they're playing it down well to him. Went past the first, went past the second, and there was no stopping that. Shit. Newcastle United a goal down. But hey, we've been goal downs before. Just ask Real Madrid. It's not a death sentence just yet. Gareth Bale! Here we go, that's Harry Kane. Harry Kane equalizes brilliantly for Newcastle. The man who scored the winner at the Bernabeu Stadium. Look at that ball from Jude Bellingham. And look at that finish from Harry Kane. Brilliant football all round. Castona to Bellingham, and look at that pass. My word. Kane got it onto his left foot and finished brilliantly for a man that many were saying Maradona was crazy to sign, especially for the price that he paid. £110 million for a player that had not scored a goal in over a year. Nobody else wanted to get into that race with PSG. And Dwight Yorke did well. crowded out in the end, but look at that, so easily holding off the Newcastle players there. Good pass there. Shea Given pulls off a great save. It's 1-1 and under 20 minutes gone. Dwight Yorke there again. Maratti. Oh, rifled in by Ross Barkley. Here's Douglas Luiz again. Oh my goodness. No, and Newcastle's agricultural defending nearly hurt them again. Here's St. Maximan now to use his pace down the flank. Had the man beat and should have just taken the win. No, came back to beat him again and got caught in possession there. And tried to find Harry Kane, Howard Bellis. Here's Castona now. Finds Gareth Bale. Bale does well here with the pace. Oh, and a poor cross. Aston Villa played well in. Oh! Shearer there. Oh my goodness. St. Maximan. Shearer for a split second was free. By the time the ball came to him, he was well marshaled there. And yes, El Ghazi, the Moroccan, I think he was the Algerian. I forget now. Oh, and does well there, El Ghazi. Dwight Yorke! Offside. Wow, wow, word. Newcastle United just cleaved open there. Yes, Castona hasn't really had an impact on the game thus far. Gareth Bale now. Does well, Gareth Bale again. Beats his man. Can he get a good cross in here? And the defender gets there ahead of Shearer. Castona gets the header in and Harry Kane gets a head to it. But that one goes wide. He's certainly grown in stature since arriving at Newcastle, Harry Kane. Harry Kane! Oh, he's missed it! Harry Kane! Good anticipation there. So which way he was coming. Tried to curl it around the goalkeeper and just overhit it in the end. It's okay, lad. You just keep trying, man. You just keep trying. Douglas Luiz there. It's half time. Newcastle 1, Aston Villa 1. And you gotta think maybe Aston Villa were the better of the teams in that first half. Maybe? Yeah, it's been a good game, guys. Howard Bellis does well there. Castona trying to initiate another attack. Takes on Douglas Luiz and gets away with it as well. Trying to find Jude Bellingham now. Who finds Allen St. Maximan. Who finds Castanet. Gets it onto his right boot. No go. Bellingham to St. Maximan. Cannot get the cross in. Oh man. No. Oh. Keeper chooses to punch away. And Aston Villa. El Ghazi. Nicely done there, Howard Bellis. Yes, Castona now. Oh, well saved. Castona.
Oh, he's really drilled it.
Made the room. Bellingham, who's done well here in his first start in Newcastle colours. Oh, that's a throw in there. It will be Newcastle's throw in, thankfully. Castona. Oh, ambitious ball. They tried to find Shearer in the box. A very crowded box. He's done well. Oh, Gareth Bale taken off there by Matt Target. Matt Target suddenly laser guided in his tackling there. And oh my goodness. Ghazi there. I think Jude Bellingham just did enough to put him off there. And what a save by Shay Given. McGinn.
Well, that was high class goalkeeping there to back up
his. Yes, swatted there. And Aston Villa, look at this. He looked a dead certainty to score there, didn't he? It was not to be.
So now we're going to get those changes.
Burton Traore coming on for Ahmad El Ghazi. And does well there. Here's Harry Kane now with only Alan Shearer for comfort.
Kane,
can he get the shot off here? Kane! Oh my goodness me! Expecting a lot from himself, body off balance on his weaker left foot. Very difficult angle as well. Trying to take it on the run. In the end, asking just too much from his own considerable skills. And here comes Kane again.
He's left his back.
Kane tried to pull back, looking for support.
Well, that is asking for trouble.
Maybe I need to make a change here. I don't know, man. Yeah, Harry Kane's had a pretty good game for me, so I'm going to drop Gareth Bale. And bring on Kieran Knight and see what he can do here for me. Jude's had a pretty good game for me. It'd be a shame to take him off. And Aston Villa, somehow that one falls to a Villa shirt.
And here's Grealish.
Jack Grealish now. Finds McGinn again. Great jokes in there. Michael Richards. Oh, Michael Richards there. Tried to get the ball away.
Aston Villa,
and here comes Marco Verratti now, looking for some options. Nobody to pass to. What the hell, dude? And Dwight Yorke got the freedom of the park here, guys.
Good take, and he's had a look.
Oh, what a tackle from Castona there. And again. No! No, that is not a penalty. No way. No, that cannot be. What the? I was tackling with Castona. Where did this dude? Oh no, that's an AI tackle. How dare you? And Dwight Yorke here. And he just rolls it into the bottom left corner. Dwight Yorke, I think, has won it for Aston Villa here. Or has he? There's still 5 minutes to go, guys. This match isn't over yet. But Aston Villa have scored the penalty. No, there was a great tackle from Castona, but Howard Bellis forgot about the ball and took out the man instead, and the penalty was given. And Dwight Yorke there, the Trinidad and Tobago international, just picked his spot and rolled it into the bottom corner. Shay Given left floundering. And Newcastle United. And look at Villa sitting completely in defensive mode here. Oh, St. Maximin. That's a foul. Surely that's a foul. A free kick here. From Burton Traore there. Yeah, that's got to be a foul, man. Okay, everybody come up here. Castellana can take this. Shearer, if there's a header to be had, I need you to take it. Everybody get into that 6-yard box. Where's my goalkeeper? Oh, he didn't come up. That's okay. Kane's there. Not to be. Hey, it's not over yet, guys. My great winger, Michael Richards. Oh, my goodness. I've got nobody back there. Marco Verratti. Chasing for all he's worth, and Gilbert does exactly what he needs to do, runs for the byline. Ah, bastard. Aston Villa come away from St. James's Park with the 3 points. Late penalty scored by Dwight Yorke. Ah, feel a little bit hard done by that one, man, I gotta say. It's like a bit of a gut punch, but then again, I guess I know what Real Madrid felt like when I beat them with two goals in injury time. Douglas Luiz is a great opener there. Nicely done by Aston Villa. But really, the guys were just ghosting past me there. Look at that. Pass Verratti. Sold Luiz a dummy. But Harry Kane here made the best of the Jude Bellingham pass and a great finish as well. And from there, we certainly tried Dwight Yorke here, probably the most presentable of chances. Well saved by Shea Given, who pulled off a couple of good saves for me today. Ross Barkley here with a good chance as well, but too many bodies in the way. And on the brink of halftime, Harry Kane with a header that went over. And Kane here read it well, for not for the first time, and went to curve it around the keeper and just over hit it there, man. Unlucky. Castanar. Good shot, but look at that, what the hell? Matt Target. Castanar again, yeah. Good shot on target and well saved by the goalkeeper. Jimmy McGinn here. Had a good shot. Look at that, took that on brilliantly, and Shea Given again. Comes to reflex saves, he is exceptional. Harry Kane here in the 72nd minute. Got the ball away from his man and whoa! That one went straight for the corner flag, and Dwight Yorke, with 4 minutes to go, just rolled it into the bottom corner as Newcastle follow up the last league victory at Elland Road with another defeat. Good game by Aston Villa though, 6 shots all on target, and they have beaten Newcastle United. Can't seem to get any consistency going here. Elsewhere, Arsenal win at home to Leeds, Liverpool away win at Blackburn Rovers, Spurs defeating Brighton, Sheffield United newly promoted defeating Norwich, Manchester United defeat Chelsea at Stamford Bridge, wow, Man City also a good away win at Goodison Park defeating Everton, West Brom defeating Leicester at home, Palace defeating Bournemouth, and West Ham defeating Wolverhampton Wanderers. What does it all mean? That Newcastle have now lost 2 of the opening 3 games, while Liverpool, Man City, Arsenal and Manchester United have won 3 from 3. United with 3-1-0 victories there. Liverpool, of course, the league's top scorers already. Come on, Newcastle. Gotta do better. Join me next time as Newcastle United travel to Anfield to face champions Liverpool. That ought to be fun. Catch you guys then. Cheers.